Hi there, it's Aryan. Today we want to explore the Vegetation Engine modules. So be sure to check out the previous video about TVE before watching this one. Today I want to showcase the blanket and train shader modules. Both are parts of the Vegetation Engine. It's important to note that the latest version of the Vegetation Engine is required for these modules to work. The train blanket module allows you to conform and align big patches of grass or groups of rocks, which would only work for flat surfaces, to the train surface and normal direction. The shaders utilize pre-baked pivots to treat each submesh as an individual object. This approach enables you to use fiber grass objects while covering larger areas, providing a performance boost for your project if your scene is set up correctly. I have installed both the train blanket and train shader. In the boxophobic directory, another folder is created called the Vegetation Engine Modules. Let's open a demo scene from Blanket. This scene is preset, so you don't need to make any adjustments. Let's play around and test it. As you can see, the grass and rocks align to the train surface and normal direction when moved. These materials use the blanket shader. If you navigate to boxophobic TVE geometry, you can observe TVE shaders, each equipped with a blanket mode shader. For assets to conform to the train, you need two elements, a vertex conform train element and a vertex orientation train. These two are preset, but you can create these elements from boxophobic TVE elements. The default setting is color tint, but it can easily be changed to vertex conform train. Additionally, you need to assign the train data to this slot. Another important aspect is to set the scale of these elements to the width and height of the train. Otherwise, issues may arise. The conform element captures the train height and is rendered in the global vertex render texture. The texture is then globally passed to the shaders. For aligned meshes to the train normals, a vertex orientation is necessary. In the material, you have the option to change the global orientation and conform. Remember that for objects like this rock, you need to disable the use pivot position for vertex. I have imported a MegaScan asset, let's convert it and use it on the train. After converting, make sure to change the shader to a blanket. This asset doesn't require use pivot position for vertex, and it may need to adjust the global orientation to a lower value. That's it. You can achieve a better looking scene and improve performance, especially if you use cluster grass instead of single grass. And you can use any TV features as you like. There is another demo, but it requires the train shader. It demonstrates the blending between the rock and the train. Thanks for watching. The next video will focus on the train shader. Don't miss it. See you next time.